The Commission on Appointments defers deliberations on the ad-interim appointment of Commission on Audit Chairman Gamaliel Cordoba. This comes after a heated exchange between Senator Risa Ontiveros and Saguip Party List Representative Rodante Marcoleta over Cordoba's role in the shutdown of ABS-CBN 2 years ago. Ontiveros asked Cordoba why he issued a cease and desist order to ABS-CBN, despite previously committing under oath that his agency would grant the network a provisional authority to operate while its franchise application was being deliberated in Congress. Cordoba argued he was only following the rule of law.
With all due respect to the good senator, may we know why we are belaboring this issue?
Oh, Ms. Madam Chair, I'm hardly belaboring the issue. Dalawang taon na ito mula nung nangyari ito. At hanggang ngayon, hindi pa rin matiyak ng nagkaisa at ng ibang labor centers kung yung higit 1,000 manggagawa ay nakapaghanap na muli ng trabaho. Hardly belaboring dahil ito po ay may kinalaman dun sa trust na ilalagak ng publiko sa chair ng COA batay sa track record na ipinakita nila bilang chair ng ibang komisyon.
Well, doon po sa hearing ngayon ay humingi po ako ng tawad at gusto kong ulitin ngayon na napasensya na po kayo at I just had to follow the rule of law.
But for a media law and ethics professor, Cordoba is not only unqualified to hold the post at the Commission on Audit, he also lacks integrity.
Ang pangunahing katangian dapat ng isang COA chair ay integrity. Integrity at independence at competence. Yun pong ginawa niya na ipinasara po yung ABS-CBN noong May 5, 2020. Nilabag po niya ang sarili niyang kautusan ng NTC at alituntunin ng NTC. Nilabag niya yung alituntunin ng NTC na dapat mayroong grace period na 60 days. Ang lahat ng mga humingi ng prangkisa. Hindi po qualified, with all due respect, ang background po ni Commissioner Cordoba ay engineering and law. Ang kailangan po sa COA na qualification dahil po nag-audit siya, obviously, ay CPA lawyer.
The Philippines not taking the Pag-asa Island incident lightly as it formally asks China to explain what really happened. Manila's Foreign Affairs Department on Thursday sent a note verbal to Beijing. It seeks clarification from China, which denies its Coast Guard forcibly took rocket debris from the Philippine Navy. Following the latest encounter, the new chief of the Philippine Navy vows to protect every inch of the country's territory.
We will adhere to and stand with the position of our Commander-in-Chief regarding our rights in the West Philippine Sea and the seas all over our archipelago. We will protect our sovereignty and territorial integrity at all times. The Philippine Navy will maintain existing partnerships and strive to build new ones through naval exercises, bilateral and multilateral engagements. We will push for the continuation of existing international engagements and work towards expanding our cooperation with regional navies, of course, aligned with our foreign policy directions.
The Philippines has filed 189 diplomatic protests against China this year alone. 61 of those are under the Marcos administration.